agitator for us.
One of those, but it's in my other pants.
You wouldn't recognize one if it fell on your head. That's why I'm going to retrieve it.
Sounds good. I'd appreciate the company.
Not as much as I'd appreciate coming back in one piece. I don't like going above ground unless there's no other option. But here we are, with our options dwindling quickly. Not to put more pressure on you, but we have to move quickly on this. Word is that the Brotherhood is nosing around the area. We don't want them getting the agitator before we do. Head on up to the relay, and I'll meet you there.
Allie.
So, what can I do for the future?
Dr. Ayo.
If you're going to be in Diamond City anytime soon, you might not be aware of it, but the city's mayor is a synth, an institute plant. He monitors developments in the Commonwealth and compiles reports on matters of possible interest to us. Since you visit the surface more than anyone else down here, I figured you could pick up the latest report.
How do we do this without raising suspicions?
You'll meet with the mayor privately, away from prying eyes. The mayor will be waiting in his office. He'll give you the report, and then you'll bring it back to me. Remember, discretion is vital to our operations in Diamond City. So try to keep a low profile.
Justin.
Yes, what is it?
I'm good for now. Thanks.
Very well.
Sounds like those raiders at Libertalia are quite a handful. From what I hear, that rogue scent at Libertalia is a real menace. Glad it's back where it belongs.
I wish you could have known Father as we have.
Thank you.
I'm not the only person here who's lost someone.
Just looking to trade a little.
Sure thing. Nothing stays hidden forever. At least, not if I have my say.
Thank you. It's like I can
hey, Piper.
Think straight.
Head my way? Yeah?
Excuse me.
You showed up just in the nick of time.
Thank you. Sir.
So you were there the day the bombs fell. That must have been terrifying.
It must make you proud to see all that Father has done, all that he has built.
Doesn't look like that'll get us anywhere. At least not without whatever card.
This is beyond me. Won't be able to hack this.
This wasn't really what I planned on doing today.
Thank you.
Allie.
Well, isn't this...
Over here. Dr. Fillmore.
Looks pretty dangerous in there. You have any sort of radiation protection on you?
Radiation protection? Like what?
Come on, you've been around a while. You want to be up to speed here. The usual stuff Commonwealthers use. Rad-X, Radaway, a suit. Anything like that. You go in there without something and you're going to be toast. Glowing, blistered toast.
So?
Can I just close my eyes and run fast?
Joking in the face of mortal danger, always a good sign. Here, I got a couple of doses of Rad-X, but I seriously doubt it'll do the job. See? This is why I wore the suit. Look, they worked on the reactor here. They must have had some kind of protection. Poke around and I'm sure you'll find something.
Thank you.
code.
Hello.
Looks pretty dangerous in there. You have any sort of radiation protection on you?
Don't worry about me. I'm all set.
Okay, good. See? This is why I wore the suit. Look, they worked on the reactor here. They must have...
Come on. Moving out. On me. Heads up. How you doing, buddy? Hey, boy. You know any tricks? Heads up. Hey. How you doing, buddy? Never mind, boy.
Dow cycling airlock. Please wait. Initiating decontamination sequence. Mission complete. You may proceed.
Hello.
Looks pretty dangerous in there. You have any sort of radiation protection on you?
Downcycling airlock. Please wait. Initiating decontamination sequence. Decontamination complete. You may proceed.
Thank you.
Us will have a hard time accepting an outsider as our next director. It won't be easy.
Dr. Fillmore.
I think that was enough excitement for, well, ever. Thank you, really. Couldn't have managed it without you. I'll make sure the agitator gets where it needs to go. I understand Father is anxious to get you involved in something else. You'd better not keep him waiting.
Thank you.
Your father's daddy, but he looks so much older than you.
Hi there.
Sometimes Quentin is really mean to me, but my mom says I have to be nice anyway.
Okay, you're sticking to the regimen. Yes. Interesting. And you've been getting extra rest. Are there many more of these questions?
Yes.
J522 around. He didn't show up for duty today, and I can't seem to find him.
Did you check robotics? He was probably scheduled for routine maintenance. I wouldn't worry about it.
I thought so too, but he wasn't in the log, and everyone I've asked hasn't seen him. He's never just missed his shift like that.
What are you saying?
I'm worried something might have happened to him. No one knows where he is. It's like he just disappeared. It doesn't feel right.
Shh. Keep your voice down. You know what happens if they hear you talking like this? They'll wipe you. I suggest you keep this to yourself.
But what if something's wrong? Look around. Corsair patrols have doubled. Synths are being wiped more frequently. Something is going on.
I don't want to hear anymore. Do whatever you want. Just leave me out of it. I know you'll achieve great things here.
Bye.
We all do.
Father has done remarkable things. I would not exist were it not for him.
Wanted to see me?
I understand mass fusion was a success, despite interference from the Brotherhood of Steel.
What did you hear?
Dr. Fillmore's report was quite thorough. The Brotherhood's intervention must be placed in a larger context, however, given their penchant for hoarding technology. Future conflict with them is guaranteed. We are, after all, keepers of the most advanced technology in the Commonwealth, if not beyond. It also cannot go unnoticed that there were concerns within the Institute about your allegiances. I, of course, never doubted your commitment to our cause. But by directly confronting the Brotherhood, I think you've put some others at ease. I'm proud of you. Regardless, the Brotherhood is an issue for the future, and we must focus on the present. And look at me, rambling on like the old man I am. I'm wasting time. You're needed elsewhere at once.
Oh, good. Here I was afraid I'd have nothing to do.
Very funny. There's something that needs your immediate attention. This situation, I'm afraid, is something of your creation, however unintentional.
I've risked myself repeatedly for the Institute, and this is what I get? Whatever's happened, it's not my fault.
Calm down. Let me explain. While you were assisting Dr. Fillmore, a second team was sent out to invite someone from the Commonwealth to join the Institute. Apparently, there was some miscommunication, and this individual called for help, which arrived in the form of your Minutemen. My understanding is that no shots have been fired. I would like it to stay that way. I need you to go there and speak to your Minutemen gathered outside. Insist that they stand down at once. Dr. Thompson is on site, and he will be your primary contact. I know you can resolve this situation, but it is of paramount importance that this special individual be brought to the Institute immediately.
I'm not going to betray the Minutemen.
I'm not asking you to. I expect that since these people have listened to you so far, they will continue to listen. Make them see reason. But please, hurry. If fighting breaks out, it will be difficult to stop.
Your presence here is a great gift. Not just to Father.
You know any tricks? Hey.
her word, kid. No more count. No more sight, either.
I just need to trade gear with you.
You don't need the sight to see that you are real worthless.
What's going on here?
You're an unexpected surprise. We could use the backup. These Institute bastards aren't getting away. They'll have to go through us to get out of there. We don't know quite what we're up against, but it's good you're here to help. How did you hear about this?
Can you bring me up to speed on the situation?
Commonwealth Citizen lives in that there observatory. Institute thugs showed up to haul him off. Only he spotted them coming. He managed to fire off a flare gun, got our attention, and we got up here as quick as we could. Now they're trapped inside. So, how do you want to play this? We thought about trying to lure them out here, since it'd be easier to kill them. But then we realized we probably ought to storm the place, to make sure they can't disappear on us. That makes sense, right? So, you want to lead the charge?
What do you know about the person who lives here?
Not too much. Wallace is his name. Kind of an egghead type, but real squirrely. Keeps to himself. We've checked in on him every now and then, but he didn't seem to want the company. So, we moving in or what?
No one is gonna do anything. Tell your men to stand down.
Are you kidding me? If we don't do something now, they're gonna take that poor guy wherever it is they go, and we'll have failed. Again, are you going to order the attack or not?
This whole thing is just a misunderstanding.
A misunderstanding? Can't wait to hear this. Explain to me how this is a misunderstanding.
You don't have all the information. I do. I'm telling you, this isn't what it looks like. That man's not in danger.
You know what? I've got all the information I need. I'm tired of you trying to confuse things. Now you get the hell out of my way. I have a citizen to protect.
Hey.
Yes?
What do you need, General?
Excuse me.
Is there something you need?
No, nothing.
Okay.
What's going on here?
You're an unexpected surprise. We could use these Institute bastards on get. We don't know quite what we're up against.
I'm not sure you know.
Oh, I know exactly what's going on. These ass. Well, not today. So. But then we realized that makes sense, right?
No one is gonna.
I don't. If we don't do something now, they're gonna. Are you gonna order the attack or not?
You'd risk that man's life? You could get him killed, too.
If we don't do anything, he's as good as dead. Are you so against this? You do know which side you're on, don't you?
I know for a fact they won't hurt.
Whoa, whoa, look! I'm not trying to get everyone here killed, okay? Fine, we won't act. But if they kidnap that guy, it's on your head.
Hey there.
Yes?
General.
You're here. I was starting to worry we might not make it out of this mess.
It wouldn't have been such a mess if you handled it differently.
I never claimed to be suited for field work, and I explicitly stated that when given this assignment. Besides, it's not my fault that Wallace called in those savages.
Those savages had you pretty well cornered.
Did I not mention the part where we didn't expect this? This was supposed to be a simple extraction. Can we just get on with this, please? I know he's potentially important to Phase 3 and all, but I'm not sure it's worth putting ourselves in harm's way.
Why did the Institute send you specifically?
They thought I'd be able to relate to him with my scientific background. I know they've been keeping an eye on him for years. Not sure how they originally found him, but probably don't want to know. But once they realized how smart he was and what an asset he could be for Phase 3, they watched pretty closely. I think they even fed him scientific material from time to time to see how good he was, you know, testing him to see if he was Institute material. Let's just get Wallace and get out of here.
What does this Wallace guy have to do with Phase 3?
Wallace is, well, brilliant by all accounts. Like nothing we'd seen in the Commonwealth prior. He truly has a gift when it comes to theoretical physics. With his help, there's just, well, there's a slight problem with that. I was thinking.
No problem. I'm sure I can get him to see reason.
I hope so. We really need him.
Ahem.
Scanning unknown identity. Clearance confirmed.
I'm looking forward to working for you, future director.
Mr. Wallace, I'm here to talk to you.
You're another one of them, aren't you? Are you a robot?
Don't be ridiculous. Of course I'm not a robot.
That's exactly what a robot would say. I've heard all the stories. I know exactly what happens to people when the Institute shows up. Well, it's not happening to me.
Hey, just calm down, okay? I just want to talk to you.
Fine, fine. What do you want from me?
The Institute needs your help, Mr. Wallace. It's as simple as that.
My help? With what?
You feeling all right? In exchange for helping us out, you'd be granted access to the most advanced research facility imaginable. Whatever research you wanted to perform, anything, it's possible there. I promise. You'd be safe and secure in a way that's completely impossible anywhere else.
You have a better option than what we're offering you?
No. No, I guess I don't. Okay, fine. I'll go.
The sooner we can get out of here, the better.
Okay. I think we've got this under control now. Thanks. I mean, thanks for the assist.
You're gonna bring him in immediately, right?
Oh, yeah. Don't want him to start second-guessing the decision. I'll see you back in the Institute.
Broken. Enrico.
The sooner we can get out of here, the better.
General?
Huh?
Hi, how are you?
Hey, General.
is more than just our leader. He is our creator.
Allie.
So, what can I do for the future director of the Institute?
There you are. I cannot express how pleased I am. Our new guest is familiarizing himself with his surroundings. Yet he's already pointed out several inefficiencies in our methods. With his help, Phase 3 will be ready in no time. And it's all thanks to you.
A lot of work went into this before I even arrived. Just how close are we?
It shouldn't take long at all. The Facilities Division has it well in hand. There is one more part for you to play, and I think you might enjoy it. It is time to announce our presence to the Commonwealth, to request that they do not interfere with our plans. You should be the one to do it.
Right. Because no one up there suspects the Institute exists.
This is not a joke. There's been too much posturing by too many groups. The world needs to know that we are in power and the Commonwealth is ours. As the incoming director, it is your responsibility to lead, to establish that place for the Institute's future. Please take this seriously. We've prepared some remarks for you to record. Once you're finished, we'll broadcast them to the entire Commonwealth. Use the microphone here and follow the script. It's quite simple. I'm sure you'll do fine, Father.
Son.
If you could, please finish up the speech. We'll need the final recording before we go too much further.
For years now, you have suspected that the Institute still exists, that we are among you. It is true, but it is not the whole truth. We're here, and we are here to help. Our superior technology represents the future of the Commonwealth. Today, we activate our nuclear reactor, ensuring that we will persevere long after the world above ground ceases to exist, ensuring that mankind has a future. We have no desire to interfere in the unimportant details of your... daily lives. We simply insist that you do not interfere with Institute operations. To do so would result in... unnecessary difficulties for all parties. Rest easy. Know that the future is... looking bright. And that mankind will thrive under our guidance.
Well, that was... interesting. Perhaps not what we originally intended, but it will certainly get your point across. Now it's time to make sure that everyone hears it. How would you feel about making a little trip to Diamond City?
I could use some fresh air.
A quaint phrase. Though I'm afraid the air there is anything but fresh. The radio station in Diamond City is listened to by many in the Commonwealth. If we'd like the people to hear what we have to say, it's the best way to reach them. Before we preempt their broadcast, we need to ensure it reaches the maximum range possible. I've been assured that the necessary parts are on site. You'll just need to install them to boost the broadcasting power. Report back when you're done. We should be ready by then.
Hey, pal.
I want to be left alone.
You shoot people, sir? My dad says ask.
Shoot people.
Hi. There.
Hi.
Don't break my stuff if you don't mind. This radio station, you'll notice there aren't any other ones. So.
No wonder it isn't broadcasting at full power. I'll need to find those radio.
Don't break my stuff if you don't mind.
Let's try this. Maybe this goes here? Alright, in you go. Hey there.
Don't break my stuff if you don't mind.
friends say outsiders smell, but you don't smell at all. But Dad says not to talk to strangers.
Yeah?
Just walk on through the gate if you need to leave.
Need something, honey? Housing permit? Looking for a job?
And you are?
Geneva, the mayor's secretary. I handle all the day-to-day.
Tell me about the permit again.
One home available, center of town, near the market. Interested?
I'll take it.
Here's the key. Let me be the first to welcome you as a resident of the Great Green Jewel.
Yeah?
As much as I love talking to the people, I'm a busy man.
Hey.
Welcome, welcome. Good to see you again. I trust you've been sent by our mutual friend, Mr. Io. I hope he's doing well.
To be honest, he's a pain in the ass.
Yes, well, sometimes it's the best way to get things done. Piper almost managed to get a hold of some compromising information. I was able to keep things out of her hands, but she's clever. I've recommended time and time again that we consider her a priority. But I understand if there are other concerns. Just let our mutual friends know that it's still a problem. Just let our mutual friends know that it's still a problem. The full details are in my report, along with some other points of interest. Here it is. Make sure that nobody sees this. Better you destroy it than let it fall into the wrong hands.
So if this shows up in public occurrences, that's bad. Got it.
Very funny. I'll let you see yourself out. Do travel safely.
Thank you.
Do give my best to our mutual friends.
Yes, sir.
Nice work bringing that boat safe.
The Institute's a big place. It might take a while to learn where everything is.
I have to admit, the third generation sensor really is something.
Efficient plasma emitters.
Dr. Fillmore.
Hi there. Something I can help you with?
I'm good for now.
Goodbye, then.
Take good care of yourself, and you won't have to say too much.
Enjoy your trip to the big city. It's done, then? The transmitter has been modified.
I'm all set. But what about the reactor?
The initial round of tests is finished. All readings are nominal, so yes. I think we're ready. I'll let you do the honors.
This, my friends,
is the moment we've all worked towards. After all your effort, the time has finally come to start our reactor. No longer will we be forced to compromise to survive. No more will we need worry about outpacing our resources. My father and I couldn't be more proud of what you have helped us accomplish. And we look forward to achieving even greater things in the future. The Institute is now truly mankind's best hope. Thank you. All of you.
Sean.
Hello, Father. I hope your time in the Institute has been enjoyable.
Son.
It's almost hard to believe. After all those years of hard work, here we are. We've arrived. Look what you've made possible.
Now that the reactor works, what's next for the Institute?
We'll get to that. There's more work to be done before the Institute's future is guaranteed. The Directorate has convened a meeting about how to proceed. I'm not going to attend. You should be there as director.
Sean.
I'm glad you could be here to share this with me.
That should prove useful in your surface missions.
Hi.
Welcome. Do you require additional supplies?
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Remember to conserve power at every opportunity.
Unit B-592 is undergoing the reclamation process as we speak. Before long, he'll be back in the workforce.
I've got the report from Diamond City.
Good. I'll take that from you. I'll let you know when I need you to pick up the next report. That's all for now.
Aren't you going to offer me something in exchange for my help?
I thought Father brought you here to help us, not to play the mercenary. I suppose I was wrong. If I have to purchase your loyalty, so be it. It's not like I have much of a choice. Here, take these. They'll probably be more useful to you than they are to me. Anyway, like I said, I'll let you know when the next report's ready to be picked up.
May I be the first to welcome you, sir. We're looking forward to working with you.
Happy to be here, Dr. Fillmore. I hope I do the position justice.
I'm sure you will.
Right now, we're all here because it's finally time to stand up for ourselves.
Let's not be dramatic, Justin.
There's nothing dramatic about it. We're in a position to push back, to assert ourselves here. That's what we've talked about all along.
To bring you up to speed, obviously there are groups in the Commonwealth that stand in opposition to the Institute's goals. With the reactor now online, we have the ability to not only expand synth production, but to project power to a much greater degree.
I'm sure the reactor will improve everyone's life. It's a great accomplishment.
Yes, but it's not just that. The Directorate has agreed that steps must be taken to ensure our safety in the long run.
Let's not beat around the bush. The Directorate has agreed that the Brotherhood of Steel needs to be eliminated.
As the incoming Director, we felt it important to inform you of the decision and get your thoughts on it. So, where do you stand?
If this has to happen, we keep the violence to a minimum. We're not out to destroy the Commonwealth.
Of course. It was never the intention to cause more harm than is necessary. As Director, it's up to you in how we focus our efforts in achieving this goal. We'd like your input on what direction we should take. Do we increase synth production or focus on weapons development?
What would the results of this choice be? I'd like to make a well-informed decision.
Well, if we increase synth production, we'd be able to deploy more of them to the Commonwealth to aid in our operations. Weapon development would improve the weapons we have available to us now, making our synths more effective in the field. Which would you prefer we focus on?
Synths are the Institute's greatest strength. The more we have, the better off we are.
Well said. I'll see that the necessary steps are taken. Thank you very much for your time, sir. That's all we have for the moment. I believe Father wished to speak with you once our meeting concluded.
Being the Director of the Institute is a serious commitment. I hope you understand that.
Apologies. I have an urgent message from Z-114.
Your quarters have flooded, sir. There is danger of extensive damage to your personal effects.
Z-114 was helping me with a project. I'm guessing this is related?
The project isn't quite ready, but due to the flooding, it may have to be good enough. Understood? To avoid any undue tragedy, please see Z-114 at once.
There you are. You've met with the director. I assume they made their intentions known? It was difficult for them to reach the decision to engage. What about you? You agree with their decision?
How long has this been coming? When did they decide on this course of action?
The arrival of the Brotherhood's airship was the final straw, really. There's just too much at stake. You can't afford to lose it all.
You know, Father, it's no secret that you worked with the Railroad in order to first reach the Institute.
The depth of your involvement with them has been called into question repeatedly. I'm sure you can guess by whom. The question is, where do you stand with them now? Do you count them amongst your allies?
I can't lie. They are allies.
Well, I appreciate your honesty. I won't ask for details. I'm sure I don't want to know. But these people, with their twisted ideology, they seek to undermine everything the Institute stands for. Surely you can see that.
How do you know what their goals are? You've never tried to engage with them.
I've dealt with them far longer than you have. I've seen what they're capable of, the lengths to which they'll go to achieve their objectives. Surely you can see that you can no longer work with them. That the time has come to put an end to them. For our sake, for our future, I'm afraid this is an order. The Railroad leadership needs to be eliminated. I expect a report when it's done.
Good evening.
Son.
The Railroad has left us with no other option. Remember that.
I can't express how truly humbling it is to stand in your presence.
From what I hear, that rogue scent at Libertalia? It was a real menace. Glad it's back where it belongs.
Higgs and Logan are no better than children throwing a temper tantrum.
So long to reach you. You must act now. The Brotherhood of Steel has discovered the location of the Railroad.
If those bastards know where we are...
I know. I was hoping for more time to organize a rebellion, but... it's clear we cannot delay. Once you secure the Railroad against the Brotherhood, tell your people we are ready to fight. Go. Now!
Things are quiet. For now.
Hey, Glory.
For every synth that makes it out, there's a round on me.
This isn't the railroad's darkest hour. We will make it through.
Z1's rebellion is ready, but we have a crisis. The Brotherhood's on their way here.
What? What are you talking about?
Notice anything suspicious?
Two of our spotters haven't checked in. That's unusual. Jesus. Quick, take this. Tom made it for you. Sounds like we're going to need it. Everyone else, mobilize. We got Brotherhood incoming. Assume defensive positions.
Just remember,
reinforce
training
Glory
tools.
In the tunnel. Move! Move! The Brotherhood? Jesus.
Wait there.
Just remember the training drills.
How'd they find us?
Desdemona.
We're cut off. The catacombs are now our only way out.
There's no other escape route?
No. The back tunnel was it. You and the others go help Glory. Win that fight, or we're all dead.
Excuse me.
Oh, shit.
I'm too damn pissed to be scared right now.
Des will get us through this. She always does. Des will get us through this. She always does.
Desdemona.
We've survived worse than this.
No, no, no! You coming into my house!
Tom.
No, no, no! You coming into my house!
None of them got past me. Damn, that stings. Listen, the railroad's always sitting on its hands. You're the best thing that's ever happened. Promise me you'll free them. All of them.
Hold on. You'll make it through.
Bullshit. Isn't there supposed to be a light?
up! Shoot to kill! For the Brotherhood! Die!
Hey there.
I leave HQ for a second, and that's when the Brotherhood hits us.
Damn!
You must have beat them, though. Their vertebrates just bugged out. How bad was it down there?
Glory's dead.
Shit. Glory? This is a nightmare.
Hopefully Dez knows our next move. Talk with her.
No! You coming into my house!
Desdemona.
You've killed the last of them, and you're still standing. I wish the same could be said for Glory. No time for that, though. The Brotherhood underestimated us badly. Their next attack will be far, far worse. So we do the unexpected. We eliminate the Brotherhood as a threat now, and the key to that is destroying their flying fortress. Pretty. Fortunately, we've got a contingency plan for that. Tom, we're activating Operation Red Glare.
What? But Red Glare requires a Brotherhood vertebrae.
Then Charmer will get you one.
Sure, I'll just swing by the local Super Duper Mart and pick one up. Need milk, too?
This isn't the time. The Brotherhood's occupied the Cambridge police station. Spotters report they almost always have a vertebrate parked on its roof. Take it. And Tom, you're going with him.
Me? In the field?
No one else can fly the damn thing. This one's for Glory. Move out.
Our number's not up yet.